In today's video, I will share with you exactly how you can make $1,000 per day selling random everyday products on Amazon, so be sure that you stay tuned. Now, I know you're probably wondering, well, why should I listen to this guy with a crazy mustache? But look, don't take it from me, take it from Arafat here, who made $1,000 on his very first day selling on Amazon, or Phil here, who made $3,300 per week on his second week selling on Amazon, and who now is going to doing over $5,000 per week. Now, if this is your very first time to my channel, consider subscribing as I drop brand new content every single Thursday at 5 p.m. Pacific about Amazon FBA, tips and tricks they can take and put to work today. Now look, there are many ways you can start selling on Amazon with, but the following two are simply the two that I have done on Amazon, and in fact, one of them simply got me started, because when I first started, I had just lost my restaurant. You know, I was $150,000 in debt, and I simply just didn't have a whole bunch of money sitting around where I could invest in products or invest in mentoring or do all these fancy things, right? So I knew that I had to start somewhere. The first method is simply called arbitrage, right? Or dropshipping. And it is simply where you actually resell other branded items on Amazon, right? And the way I did it is that I would go to stores like, you know, thrift stores, dollar stores. In fact, right here is a video that I made, you know, a while back where I was actually drop shipping a dollar store item, or a couple items actually, onto Amazon, right? And, or you can even go to like Walmart, TJ Maxx. I still remember one of the very first products that I sold on Amazon that actually made me a killer profit was a toy, some doll, you know, I can't remember what the company was called, but I was simply buying it for about $17, $18 from TJ Maxx, and then, or Home Goods actually, and then I was selling it on Amazon for about $32. Now, Amazon does take some fees. There was also, you know, the shipping fees involved. However, I was profiting about $14, $15 per unit, you know, selling, flipping these products literally from a store, flipping them on Amazon. So with this method, you can simply just go out and start making money as early as tomorrow morning, right? With this method, you do need some money up front, because you do have to be able to buy the product, ship it to Amazon, but you're not buying in bulk, right? You're not buying in massive bulk. You're kind of, you know, flipping a few products here and there. Now, there is a criteria that I follow. You know, I make sure that there's what is called a BSR, which is a bestseller's rank. I make sure that it's below 75,000. I also make sure that whenever I scan this product to make sure that it sells on Amazon, that there wouldn't be more than 10 different sellers on that specific listing or selling that specific product, right? And what that tells me is that I can at least sell 5 to 10 units per day of that one specific product. And if you think about it, if you're making $15 or $10, $15 per, you know, per day or per unit, per product, right, you're making about $50 to $100 per day, and that's on just one product. That's completely net profits, right, not sales. Your sales could be about as high as $300 to $500 per day, right? And that's off of just one product. Now, the other method that is an extension of that is drop shipping on Amazon, which is simply by, and you do that online, right? It's simply by finding products that sell well on Amazon again, but not in retail stores, and instead of buying these products up front, you simply list them on Amazon, and then once someone buys your listing or your product on Amazon, then you go and buy the product off of those websites and then have them ship directly to the customer, right? Once again, this method, you don't need a whole bunch of money up front, because you're not really, you know, spending money until you get paid, right? Or until the customer buys your product. So that way you're not sitting on a bunch of units that are not really making you sales. And you can list many other products, because you don't have to buy this product. You can literally sell, you know, list 20 different products. And then if each one of them even sells one unit per day, that's, you know, 20 units per day. And if each one of them is making you $10 in net profits, that's $200 a day times, you know, times 30, that's $6,000 per month of passive income that's coming in, where you're not really putting in a whole bunch of money up front. And those were the two methods that I personally started, because, you know, once again, I was $150,000 in debt when I first began, and I just didn't have a whole bunch of money up front that I can dedicate for products. So the second concept is called private labeling. And that's simply where, you know, you find a product that already sells well on Amazon. You know, we're not inventing new products or anything, but try to see what like holes in the markets there are, right? Whether if it's reading bad reviews, you know, seeing what other people like to buy with that one product, bundling it with another product, and then simply, you know, creating a variation of that product that doesn't exist on the marketplace, putting our own logo, our own label on it, creating our own brand of that product. As I mentioned earlier, this is a concept that you do need some type of capital, upfront capital, because you are gonna be stocking you know, some inventory. However, the awesome thing about this concept is the fact that you can scale. You know, the scale is massive. Like one of our, you know, most recent $100,000 a month students, Marie, like you can see on the screen here, you know, she went, now she didn't start with this when she was at zero. You know, she was making a couple thousand dollars a month, but within a few months, she was able to make $105,000 in the last 30 days. And that's simply because she found a niche, she found, you know, a need in the market, and then she was able to tackle it, right? So simply what you do is you're gonna find a manufacturer that can manufacture that specific product that you want to sell, get it shipped directly to Amazon, and then Amazon fulfills the orders. They send the orders to the customer, they store the units in their warehouses, they do customer service. So you as a seller are not involved in the day-to-day operations, you are not involved in the, you know, customer service. It's a lot more passive, a lot more scalable. You know, the downside is that you do need some upfront capital, but it's definitely doable, and that is currently the concept that I personally do. Guys, I truly hope that you guys found value in this video. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up, and also consider subscribing if it is your first time, and share this video with your friends. Now, if you're like, you know what, Bashar, this sounds awesome and I really want to give, you know, become part of this Amazon thing, but, you know, I would rather have someone kind of walk me through the steps and really kind of show me, like, how do I select the product? How do I ship it to Amazon? How do I market it? How do I do everything, right? What I have done is I have made available on my team's calendar a couple spots where we'll jump on the phone with you, figure out exactly where you are, and see if we can help you and if you are a good fit to work with me directly, right? So if you want to get involved, there is an application process. There's a link in the comment section below. Click on it, fill out the application. Let's jump on a call either with me or one of my team members, and let's figure out how we can help you. So once again, guys, Bashar Kattu here. Thank you very much for tuning in. I'll see you guys next Tuesday at 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern. Have yourselves a great week and take care.